Well, good afternoon, Assembly. Sorry, there's no snazzy video this year in respect of time, but I am teaching Elder Mark Ingles, Chaplain Endorser for the EPC, and as I am speaking, I would like to invite the chaplains in our midst to please come on up to the stage, and we'll kind of V off to here and off to here, and let's... Wow, that's great. Thank you all. You can do that later as well. So, well, it truly is a tremendous joy to be with you here with these wonderful chaplains and also some members of the Chaplain Work and Care Committee. Coordinating with Presbyteries, I and the Chaplain Work and Care Committee, supported by Jerry I. Murray and also Zenaida Bermudez, are involved in approving EPC teaching elders to serve as chaplains. And the full CWCC report, Chaplain Work and Care Committee report, is included on the EPC website. And I also prepared kind of an endorser report of report and words of encouragement that weren't in the Chaplain Work and Care Committee report. And you can just email me if you'd like a copy of that and I'll send it to you. So no worries. And it's just a great way to find out what's going on with the chaplaincy beyond what you'll hear in this very short get-together. So you'll also notice on the website, let's see, on the screen, well, it's not on there. If you want to find out what the, it's basically epc.org. Oh, there it is. I ask and I shall receive. Okay. So yeah, my email is there and also the website for chaplaincy if you know of people that are interested in your midst in the chaplaincy. So brothers and sisters, chaplains are pastors with specialized training who serve in institutional settings such as prisons and law enforcement and hospitals and hospice and palliative care and long-term care opportunities, military, large companies, and other institutional settings. And as specially trained ministers of the gospel, they are called by God. They're ordained to minister outside the walls of the church. They provide compassionate care and seek to encourage others in relationship with Jesus Christ and support those going through tough life situations. I think, who here, raise your hand, has ever experienced a chaplain in your life? Raise your hand. Okay, wow. So you know a lot of what I'm talking about. So it's truly amazing ministry. They give hope to the hopeless, help to the helpless, comfort to those in the most desperate times of life. And chaplains operate on the cutting edge. They commit themselves to being available to those who are suffering, who are alienated, who are confused. They struggle with those who have perplexing questions about suffering and death and what life's about. So the reputation for excellence in pastoral care of our denominational chaplains should be celebrated as a wonderful gift from God to the men and women in the institutions for which these chaplains serve and minister. As shown so vividly here at Cherry Creek Pres, and also these chaplains, truly amazing ministry occurs both inside and outside the walls of the church, and we thank God for them both. So with more than 60 EPC chaplains, I would like to introduce the 22 of the 26 chaplains who were able to make it to GA this year. Hopefully maybe we'll get all 60, hopes a little bit bigger, so we can get everybody up here on that without making too many layers. Four of the 26 have already returned to work because their demands are so necessary and they couldn't be gone. 35 were not able to join us because of their work or current location or mission requirements. So chaplains, when I call your name, probably because of the way this is, raise up your hand so they can know who I'm talking about instead of stepping forward, because I think you'd be stepping onto the table here possibly. While I'm sharing about you to the assembly, and I would ask that you gave such a beautifully round, oh, that meant so much to me and to them, I know, a round of applause to them, but just hold any additional applause until the very end. So first one, John Bauer. Where are you, John? There you are. Okay, so John serves as a hospice chaplain for Buckeye Hospice in Youngstown, Ohio. Andy Byers. All right, Andy is currently in chaplain residency with the VA hospital in Sioux Falls, South Dakota. Marty Carpenter. Marty is in process of being ordained with the Presbytery of the Pacific Southwest and currently serving as chaplain for the police department. Get that phone. So anyway, police department in Sanger, California. Matthew Duche. Matthew, where are you? Oh, there you are. Okay, Matthew is an active duty Air Force captain serving chaplain for the United States Air Force up at Fairchild Air Force Base in Washington State, and is also the chaplain for the SEER School, which trains in survival, evasion, resistance, and escape. Sounds kind of like preparing for a GA. Anyway. Jeff didn't throw anything at me, so that was good. Matthew is actually in process of transferring his ordination to the EPC, so we're very excited about that. So, yeah. Marty Fields, next to me. He's an Air Force National Guard Lieutenant Colonel, serving as the chaplain for the 171st Air Wing in Gulfport, Mississippi. He recently returned from a 3-month deployment to Antarctica. Being selected to serve in that role is highly competitive, and we're honored that two of them have actually been EPC chaplains. So John Torres, where are you? So John was another one. I'll talk about you in a sec, being the other one. Do you know what they call Presbyterian chaplains who are selected to serve in Antarctica? Frozen chosen. Very good. Frozen chosen. Well done. All right. You saw that one coming. Yeah, I know. All right, well, back to Marty. Marty also works with Third Millennium Ministries. Helen Francell. Helen serves as hospice chaplain for Capital Caring in Manassas, Virginia. Mike Guthrie. Where are you, Mike? Is he here? Okay, Mike Guthrie, who is not here, is director of chaplaincy at Presbyterian St. Luke's, actually, at Medical Center here in Denver. Scott Kennaugh. There, Scott, an active duty Army major, is serving as brigade chaplain for the 16th Military Police at Fort Bragg, North Carolina, as well as holding position of senior pastor at the Pope Chapel on Bragg. Brad Kenny, there he is. Reverend Brad is the founder and executive director of Soccer Chaplains United and serves as lead chaplain for the Colorado Rapids and Valor Christian High School here in Denver, Colorado. I've heard his position is a kick. Anyway. I didn't even write that down. I just came up with that. Okay. Jason Kim. Where are you, Jason? Jason is an active duty Air Force major, serves as the deputy wing chaplain at Nellis Air Force Base in Nevada. He recently returned from a year-long remote assignment in Kunsan, Korea, and was very glad to reunite with his family upon his move to Nellis. Brian Kanejin. There he is. Brian is an Army Reserve captain. He serves as chaplain for the Army Reserves in Tampa, Florida. With his home in Orlando, Brian also works with crew in that city. Jeff McKinney. All right, Jeff, an active duty Army Lieutenant Colonel, is serving as the Deputy Command Chaplain for U.S. Special Operations Command at Fort Bragg in North Carolina. And I believe his wife is in the audience today. Sarah, where are you? Stand on up. So I tell you, yes. I tell you, chaplains without their spouses would be really difficult to do their ministry. So, BJ Newman. He's an Air Force National Guard captain, serves as chaplain for the Ohio National Guard, Air National Guard, 170th Wing in Springfield, Ohio, and he's also pastor at Kirkbont Presbyterian Church in Beaver Creek, right, Ohio. Jennifer Prechter. Jennifer is a pediatric palliative care chaplain for the Arnold Palmer Medical Association, which is also the Arnold Palmer Hospital for Children. Yes. Is that right? Yep. In Orlando, Florida. Incredible work that she does. She's also part of the Chaplain Working Care Committee And I have to say, after a year-long wait, since her and two others coming on board couldn't be done since there weren't enough commissioners to vote, when we came to that, I praise God for the chains and rules yesterday. So, yes. All right. Scott Rash. All right. Scott is a hospice chaplain for Liberty Hospital in Liberty, Missouri. John Richards? John? Where are you? Oh, there he is. John Richards is an Army Reserve major, serves as Deputy Command Chaplain, Army Reserve Sustainment Command in Birmingham, Alabama. And he's also pastoring a Covenant Presbyterian Church in Columbus, Mississippi. Jason Riggs. Jason serves as clinical chaplain at the VA Medical Center in Salisbury, North Carolina. David Snyder. David? Oh, right behind. David Snyder is an active duty Army Lieutenant Colonel. He's the Command Chaplain, U.S. Army Combat Capabilities Development Command. Why don't they shorten those things? Anyway, Aberdeen Proving Ground in Maryland. Rachel Torres. Rachel, you here? Oh, there you are. So Rachel, another Taurus. Rachel serves as both the Dean of Spiritual Formation and Chaplain for Montreat College in Montreat, North Carolina. Rachel is in process of coming under the support of the Chaplain Work and Care Committee, so that's going to be great. Let's see, Ted Trumbull. Oh, no, excuse me, John Taurus, not related. John is Air National Guard Lieutenant Colonel, serves as Chaplain at Stewart Air Force Base, National Guard Base in Newburgh, New York. John is also the pastor at Goodwill Church in Montgomery, New York. Ted Trumbull, the Scrubs man. So Ted serves as staff chaplain for the Aurora Bay Care Medical Center in Green Bay, Wisconsin. He's also the pastor of Christ Alone Church. And he didn't ask me to say this, but he's retiring from the church later this year. You heard him talk. If interested, see him. PJ Werner. PJ, yay, an active duty Air Force captain, serves as the group chaplain, 693rd Intelligence, Surveillance, and Reconnaissance Group at Ramstein Air Base in Germany. So he came all the way from Germany to be with us. So great to have you, PJ. The four chaplains who were here earlier but returned back to work just expressed their appreciation and love to the assembly. Karen Bolte, who's a hospice chaplain, Doug Overall, Spiritual Ministries Director in Loveland, Colorado, and Vanessa Platek, who's currently coming on board. She's currently serving as professor of theology, actually, at ORU. She'll be becoming our newest Navy chaplain. And then John Rhodes, who is going over to Batesville, Arkansas, to serve at Kindred Hospice. I also want to introduce two members of the Chaplain Work and Care Committee. Teaching Elder Brad Yorton. There's Brad over here, former Navy chaplain, right? Who? And Marine Colonel retired. You're going to be able to figure out who that is. Richard Swedberg. Where are you, Richard? So there he is back there. So, yeah. And he's part of the Chaplain Care Committee. So Presbyterians, I just want to encourage you. Did I miss anyone?
Yeah.
Oh, there it is. Okay, so Presbyteries, I really want to encourage you, take care of your chaplains and your miss. They serve often in isolation, and they need your support, your love, your encouragement, your presence in their lives, your prayers, as they serve the Lord to those that have been placed before them. The strength of prayer is amazing, as you know. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. So, Colossians 9:12 tells us to not stop praying, to fill those we are praying for with wisdom and spiritual understanding and patience and strength and endurance and so much more. So I would like to ask you now to please join me in prayer. Just stretch out your hand, scratch the person's head in front of them, and then stretch out your hand, and just join me as I pray for these wonderful chaplains. Let's pray. Father God, I would ask that you just give our chaplains the full knowledge of your will in all things, at all times, personally and for those entrusted to them that they've been called to go and minister to. And Father, fill our chaplains with your wisdom and perspective and spiritual understanding and about all the things in their life, their work, and in their calling, God. Father, our chaplains represent you everywhere they go. May they walk in a way that would exemplify you to all persons, actions and life always pleasing to you and bearing fruit in every way before others. God, give our chaplains your strength to endure stress, suffering, frustration, attacks from the evil one that can come along with ministry. God, strengthen them with your power that fills them with spiritual life daily, including the difficult days of life and ministry. persevering because of you with a measure of joy and thanksgiving. God bless our chaplains as they go from here and back to those places you have called them to. We just thank you. We thank you, Jesus. In your holy name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, now you know you did it already, but please show your appreciation to them.